When you are newbie to dropshipping, there are a lot of things that you can do and mistakes on them and basically destroy your business in just a few minutes. So, what things a dropshipping newbie must avoid when they start to do dropshipping? Stay tuned, I will explain you exactly everything you need to know as dropshipping newbie. Welcome to Cardrop YouTube channel. I'm Daniel, I'm the CEO of Cardrop, and I have 7 years experience as dropshipper on eBay. And today I want to walk with you exactly which most common mistakes dropshipping newbie does and how you can avoid it. So if you are a dropshipping newbie, this video is specially for you. So stay for this whole video and you can basically save your business life with just a few minutes of watching this content. If you are new here, subscribe down below for our YouTube channel for more videos and tutorials about dropshipping on eBay. It's 100% free, so why don't you? Also, if you can smash that like button for more videos and tutorials, as I said before. So let's jump to the point. Which mistakes dropshipping newbies must avoid and how I can help you. So as dropshipping newbie, first of all, you must avoid stealth account, in my opinion. Always open Pioneer account on your real name, real information. If you can't, it's another problem for another video, but don't use stealth account because it will basically hold up for 2-3 months and then Pioneer or eBay will ask some verification and it's not legal. Okay, so it's not legal, so don't use stealth account on fake person's ID. It can hurt your business and you can also go to jail for that, so be aware of that. Mistake number two, understand that these business are not easy as people mention. Don't look for shortcuts. Easy. Don't look for shortcut. Don't think that if you can invest your money at the start, it will help you generate more money. It's indeed correct, but not at the start of the business. When you are starting a new business, you need to learn it, to develop it, to apply the business. Basically, you need to do everything in the business. After you did everything and you understand exactly what to do, step by step, only after that you can bring a VA, you can bring a person that will help you manage your store. But don't bring a VA from the first moment that you started dropshipping. It can make you a lot of damage because you won't know how to manage and handle your VA. Invest in your listing. It's not the quantity, it's the quality. You can be very much successful with just 50 listings and you can be very much bad with even 1,000 listings. So invest in your listing when you're doing market research, optimization, title building. Basically, invest in everything in the listing. Invest in your business. It's super important. Don't do drastic things on eBay. For example, upload 50 products at one day, delete 100 products at one day. eBay don't like drastic changes and will probably ban you by MC011 because they won't trust you and they will ask some verification from you, supplier, identity, and a lot of things that can hurt your business. And basically, it's really hard to reinstate your account after getting MC011. So pay attention for that. Don't sell Vero products. Just don't. Don't sell Vero products. When you are selling Vero products, if you don't know what is Vero products, it's copyrighted items that eBay aren't allowed. In the best case, eBay will remove the item from your store. In the worst case, you can get a lawsuit from the company because you use their trademark without their permission, without authorization. You will just get a lawsuit, which not very nice. So be aware of Vero. Be aware of Vero. You don't want to upload Vero items. It's a great profit for sure, but it's not allowed by eBay and it can get you too much mess in your personal life and in your business. So be aware of that. Make yourself a favor. When you open a new eBay account, make it an linked eBay account. Linked eBay account means that if you have 10 eBay accounts, they are linked to each other. So if one going down, all of the 9 going with him. But if it's unlinked account, so eBay doesn't know you have this eBay account, you have 10 account, one falling down, you have left 9 eBay account, and it's all okay from your point because eBay doesn't know. So be aware of that. Again, if you can smash that like button, subscribe to our YouTube channel down below for more videos and tutorials about dropshipping on eBay. It will really help a lot. We are just want to help the dropshipping community as much as we can. Another thing is don't use API softwares that making you repricing, auto ordering, and more of things that basically API like monitor do. If you want to work with a monitor or a lister, it doesn't matter. Just make sure it's non-API, and when you are working with API softwares, it's a big problem for you guys because you will account, will get suspension, and probably will get flagged. And it's really hard to remove that from the account. So just don't work with API softwares that doing these actions. We actually have a full video tutorial about it. You can check it in our YouTube channel, but just work by eBay policy. And the last tip I want to give you guys is don't do dropshipping from Amazon. When you are doing dropshipping from Amazon, you will probably get flagged even if you are using non-API lister because eBay aren't allowing to do dropshipping from retailers like Amazon. So just follow eBay policy. Eventually, we are selling on eBay platform. So eBay is the boss and we are working by eBay. So just work by eBay policy and everything will be good, will be amazing. So that's it for today's video. Thank you very much for watching and we'll see you next time. Bye-bye.